heart, Frank.
Even his own family may not understand just what he does as breadwinner.
Hey, boys. Why don't you raise that with a rope and pulley?
Giving advice like that, for a fee, is what a consulting engineer does. Only his clients usually have problems a little more complex than getting a mattress up into a treehouse. His range of professional interest and competence spans the reaches of outer space and probes the inner space of human personality. Where is the consulting engineer in this picture? Well, he designed the operating theater, its power supply system, its lighting, its air conditioning and heating. And his work makes possible most of the equipment of modern medical science. By training and experience, the consulting engineer is preeminently qualified to work on most of the major problems currently facing us. And he does. But all he has to sell is time and talent. And that on a business basis. He earns his livelihood by making choices between design alternatives. Such choices must be made at every step on any project. And the consulting engineer's job is to choose that which will best serve the interests of his client. The tangible product of his work are plans in the form of drawings and specifications. As a businessman, he has to be concerned with politics, with economics, with salesmanship. He has to operate at a profit and provide for the growth and stability of his firm. Professionally, he is concerned with blighted cities, polluted air and water, tangled transportation, and decay in rural America.
Well, he's gone all the time. He's very busy, but I really don't know what he does away from home.
His wife may not know for sure what he does, but his services are sought around the world, wherever men are committed to improving the human condition by developing their resources through science and technology.
Is what we call in the old country fine Albert's girl? You have no word for that in your language.
A one-man gang, I think he means.
That's good. That's very good. Not bad at all.
But not altogether accurate. There are consulting engineers who specialize in one field, and there are firms in general private practice who are staffed by specialists. However, in an age of specialization, the consulting engineer is a generalist. He must be, because his practice may take him anywhere in, on, under, or out of this world. Each assignment is likely to be different in size, in complexity, in cost, in its social and political ramifications.